In an era where we are more and more concerned about the future of our planet, we are confronted with some big food challenges. It is estimated that in 2050, there will be 9 billion people on Earth, which is twice as many people as in 1980 and 9 times as many as in 1800, and just as many mouths to feed. Not to mention that our eating habits are also changing. Over the course of a century, we have gone from getting our protein mostly from plants to mostly from animal products. The challenge? To make better use of our resources to ensure access, without excess, to a balanced diet for the entire population, while protecting the planet and its inhabitants. To achieve a sustainable food supply, one solution that has been suggested is to diversify our protein sources, notably by rebalancing our consumption of proteins from animal and vegetable sources. But what does that really mean? Let's start with the basics. What is a protein? Just like sugars and fats, proteins are an essential part of our diet. They are made up of different elements, amino acids, which are absorbed during digestion and play a key role in forming the structure of our muscles, skin, and bones. Some of these amino acids are considered essential because our bodies cannot make them, so they have to be obtained from food. The essential amino acid composition of a protein defines its quality. These days, animal products are the main source of protein in our diets. However, protein can also be found in a large number of plant-based foods, algae, grains like oats or wheat, in quinoa, but also in almonds, hazelnuts, some vegetables like peas, and finally pulses like chickpeas, green lentils, yellow lentils, brown lentils, red beans, white beans, black beans, and so many more. There's something for everyone. So why do consumers not always feel like they've found their perfect match? Easy to transport and store, cheap and filling, pulses have been most popular in times of food shortages. But their image of being poor man's meat, which is not very inspiring, has stuck. While pulses make some people think of rich farmland and traditional cooking, other people think that they are insipid, take a long time to cook, and are boring to eat. To put pulses back in the spotlight, 2016 was declared International Year of Pulses by the FAO. And with good reason. Growing pulses, if it is done responsibly, has many benefits for the environment. Decreased emission of greenhouse gases, better soil quality and fertility, preservation of biodiversity, reduced use of nitrogen fertilizers, and lower production costs. Vegetables that contain protein, like pulses, also have useful nutritional properties, as they contain fiber, vitamins, and minerals. And while vegetable proteins sometimes have a less optimal amino acid composition than the proteins found in meat, they can be at least as nutritious. The amino acid composition of the proteins found in pulses is complementary to that of proteins found in cereals. So, for people who do not eat animal products, it is good to know that eating pulses and grains at the same meal is a good way to achieve an optimal protein intake. So the game's not over yet for pulses. In fact, our ancestors understood the importance of pulses and developed delicious recipes that traditionally combine pulses and grain, such as Moroccan couscous and Mexican tacos, for example. What about you? Are you ready to meet the challenges of tomorrow? You don't have to say goodbye to Sunday roast. Just learn to eat a more varied diet by enjoying all that the world of vegetable proteins has to offer. Pulses can be eaten in all kinds of ways. Pre-cooked if you're busy, in a casserole if you're traditional, in a burger if you're a foodie. Try our recipes from the past and invent the recipes of the future. One small pea for man, a giant leap for humanity.